just woke up. Walking up to go try to wake up Katrina. It's so creepy walking through a hospital by yourself when it's abandoned and this decrepit.
Nick?
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
It was like the worst sleep I've ever had in my life. Just kept feeling like something was gonna attack me.
This is amazing that you slept on this. That's pretty rugged.
This is one of the grittiest locations.
This is the grittiest. I think it's the worst.
Day two, here we go.
Good morning, everybody.
Hello? Hello?
Are there any patients in this hallway that need help?
Sister Johanna, are you here?
I'm here.
Yeah, I'm here. Oh my God, that was amazing.
Hi, I hope we're not disturbing you by being here.
She's talking to you.
We just came here to check out your beautiful hospital. And we heard you did a lot of really good work.
Sure. Sister Johanna, you seem really like a nice lady. There she is.
Can you see us right now?
That was pretty amazing. I was not expecting that this morning.
Yes, I'm here.
Yeah.
Please speak with us later and help us out. We're trying to look for somebody who's not being nice at this place. Somebody who's attacking people. Maybe you can point us in the direction and lead us there so we can try to figure out why this person is angry.
That was pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, that was neat.
We make our way down to the morgue. An obvious center for spirit activity.
No.
It's bad down here.
This is straight out of a horror movie. Watch where you step.
Yeah.
Hello, is there anyone in here that wants to talk to us?
I'm gonna go night vision. We know that there was a death. Somebody accidentally fell down this elevator shaft and died right here.
If you think about it though, the elevator connects all the floors to the morgue.
The elevator connects the whole entire hospital.
Yep.
All the people, all the bodies, they came through here, down the elevator to the morgue right here.
This energy is in this kind of elevator shaft.
Katrina, I'm gonna do something pretty crazy.
Are you gonna jump in there?
I have to. Just trying to
get to the bottom of what Valerie wants. She wants to know who else is here. Besides the spirits, we already know that it's attacking people.
That's really dangerous. Jesus.
That elevator has not been serviced since 2003. And that is a very heavy piece of metal sitting above Nick.
What is your name?
Oh. Your voice.
Your voice? What about it?
What about my voice?
What was that?
It's someone screaming, going, ah! What's the matter? Are you screaming? Who needs help?
This is scary.
It's getting really, the energy is changing right here. It's feeling. There's something here with me, Katrina. Are you right here in front of me? This is so weird. Whoa.
Watch out. Is that what it said?
Katrina, something's happening.
Oh my God.
I think you should get out of there.
You need help.
You need help?
No.
Oh. You okay?
Oh, I gotta shake it off. It's like super overwhelming, like. Did you feel anything out here? When I was in there...
I was so focused on you not getting killed.
This evidence shows the elevator shaft as a central artery of the building. When our cameraman Rob joins us, we continue our investigation upstairs on the third floor, sticking close to the elevator to see if the energy connects through it.
All right, here's the elevator. So I have an idea. I don't even know if this is gonna open.
Oh my God, please be careful.
Holy crap, this is heavy. Cobwebs. I felt just all this energy, this static charge, and just this weird feeling.
No. You're not gonna get in there.
Do you think it would, I'd get hurt if I jumped in?
Yes.
I don't know, I'm just curious.
Oh my God, Nick, please don't do that. Please don't do that. That thing hasn't been serviced in 13 years.
I know. I bet you it would hold me, though.
Don't go in there. We don't know how that's still up there, man. It's only a matter of time until that crashes down. Let's not do that.
Let's not do that.
All right, so we'll try your idea first. If your idea
doesn't work,
I'm going to the next level.
This is Katrina, Nick, and Rob, third floor, placing the recorder in the elevator, and it's... Who is screaming in the elevator? Is there somebody who is in pain?
Rose, can you come out of your room in 311? Somebody named Rich was speaking to us. Or you were telling me about a man named Rich. Can you tell us his last name? There's a lot of people that came through this hospital. Can you try to help us out? Thanks for talking. Rose, can you come out of your room in 311? Somebody named Rich was speaking to us. Or you were telling me about a man named Rich. Can you tell us his last name? Or you were telling me about a man named Rich. Can you tell us his last name?
Just go over to that.
What was that? Careful.
Right here.
It was right here. It was like, and it came up right here. Did you see that?
Huh.
What?
This is the room where they saw the hand.
This is the room.
In this back room.
Let me check this out.
Do you think something fell?
There's nothing like that that have that much impact. It's just like paint peeling off. First off, even if it was a little pigeon coming through this window, there's no way. And coming through this way, and a pigeon flying this way, and just going, nope, I'm just gonna flap my wings right here and blow all this dust up and turn around and go back and us not see that. This is incredible. To me, this is groundbreaking. I haven't been to a location in a long time where the daytime hauntings are more active than the nighttime. That was weird. That was the weirdest thing I've seen being at this place so far. But this is why we live at the locations, because of activity like this, not missing a second.